mission, Joker.
Let's go.
Okay.
Roger that.
Here I come.
Let's do this.
It's my
Leave
turn.
It to me.
Persona 5 Tactica.
Where'd we end up now?
Looking at the building, it reminds me of a school. It sure isn't Shujin, though.
Hey, do you think we finally made it back to our own world? We're not in a weird-ass time warp anymore. We've gotta be home.
No, take a closer look. The place is a mess, and there are speakers all over. Not only that, look how you're dressed. Pretty sure we're still in the metaverse.
Ah, good point there. Man, all this portal stuff's really messing with my head.
This place is...
Do you recognize it, Toshiro?
I get the feeling that I should know it, but I'm still unable to recall exactly.
Based on past experience, it stands to reason that this place has a tyrannical ruler as well.
Yes, we certainly can't rule that out. Granted, we also shouldn't assume it'll be the same as it was with Marie and Yoshiki.
Wait, that means we still haven't made it back to Irina's world, huh?
We definitely have to consider how we might get her back there, yeah.
Irina? What's wrong?
Oh, nothing. It's just a strange feeling I'm getting. Isn't the air here almost suffocating? So you feel it too? I'm not sure what the words are for it. It's like there's more tension in the air than before.
Really? I sure don't feel it.
What say we head inside? Standing out here won't serve us any further.
That's true. We should learn whatever we can about this place. Bear in mind, we have no idea what's in there, so be careful.
It actually looks pretty normal in here, huh? And look! Huh, our regular clothes are back.
Ah, we finally made it to... another weird place. Let's take a look at Mona.
But if we've changed, at least, does that mean we're safe here? Like at the hideout?
In theory, yes. But there's still too much we don't know about this place. Stay on guard, Joker.
Man, ain't anyone here? It's too damn quiet.
The entire building seems vacant. It'd take forever to check every single classroom, though.
Our attire hasn't changed again. I pray that means we won't be running into trouble.
Well, a rather out-of-place one. I wouldn't assume it's mere decoration, but I also can't imagine what may lie beyond it.
Oh, it opened!
Man, I can't tell what's on the other side. Can any of you?
I'd be willing to bet it connects to a different world. What's the plan?
Yes. To be fair, it's definitely a risk. But I've made up my mind already. I must keep moving forward.
Agreed. Simply wandering these halls forever won't do us any good.
All right, folks. No getting cold feet. We'll go on the count of three. 1, 2, 3!
Where are we?
Back in fighting form, guys.
So, we finally landed in enemy territory. Be careful, everyone.
Atmosphere, smoldering landscape, stench of death in the air. It's as if we've literally entered some sort of hell.
Whatever the hell this is, don't you hear something? Like voices?
So,
he's the one who
is
Strix's
nose off.
He's all the head. He's pushing us.
Some speakers? Who's doing it here?
Those voices. I wish I knew what they were talking about.
Would you like to create a weapon?
Thank you.
select a persona. Please, do you wish to withdraw this persona? Are you finished? You wish to dismantle a weapon. Which weapon will you choose? What would you like to do? The awakening of a new... Now then, make your decision. Now then, make your decision. Are you finished? What would you like to... Which persona will you choose? Which persona will you choose? What would you like to do? What would you like to do? Until next time.
Do here.
whip them into shape. Here I go.
Now
then. I'll show no mind ready.
All right.
Nice one, Joker. You'll be safe there.
Persona! Persona! Arsene!
You'll get no mercy.
My turn.
Nice move, Panther. A stylish infiltration.
Fire!
Panther shot, hit the mark.
do here?
Repositioning, Joker! Whip him in.
You'll get no mercy!
All right.
I'll show no
mercy.
Here
I go! That's perfect! You'll be safe there!
Checkmate.
do. They're attacking us. Whatever the reason, we should prepare for more hostility.
So, what's the deal with this place?
I scanned the entire area during the fight. But this place doesn't seem to lead anywhere else. It's just some kind of sealed-off zone.
What is it, Arena? You're looking pretty beat.
Yeah, I'm fine. I probably just overdid it a little.
And Toshiro, you're drenched in sweat. Are you about to throw up?
Oh, it's nothing at all. I'm just feeling a bit too warm in this suit. It's heavier weight for winter, that's all.
Come on, let's get back to the hallway. This place is just too much to handle. If we stay any longer, I might just lose it.
Yeah, we don't need to stick around. We can hash out our next steps when we're at it.
What's on the other side of the door now?
Too bad it didn't help us get home.
What's next? Should we search for a similar door elsewhere?
Don't move a muscle! We've come to stop you!
Oh, what now?
We'll decide what now. You're legionnaires, aren't you?
If you are, you already know what we'll do with you, and don't bother lying.
Wait, now, we swear, we are not your enemy.
What happened was, we wound up in this world by accident, and now we're trying to find our way out.
Really? I hadn't heard that one before. Well, if you make any wrong moves, we're tying you all up anyway.
So, has anyone else noticed how they're...
How they're the most tightly wound hat people we've met so far?
Indeed. I believe it'd be in our best interest to avoid provoking them further.
You're trying to get to your home. Unfortunately, none of us are able to leave here.
Huh? Why's that?
This entire place has been
another door, another place that needs a revolution.
Indeed! And we're the ones who shall kick it off and liberate this place! Permanently! And that's why we members of the Rebel Club are too preoccupied to help you escape!
And we're in quite a bind. We don't even have any useful leads.
I suppose we could help you on the intel front, if you're willing to join our rebellion.
I see. A quid pro quo scenario. Terms do sound reasonable enough at this point. Thoughts, Joker? That's true. We'd be remiss to take any deal too hastily. There's much that we still don't know. How about we ask them for some context? Any final decisions can come after that.
You heard the guys.
We need more deets before we sign up for anything.
So be it. All of you, follow me! We've reached our hideout. Enter!
All right, let's see here. It's another LeBlanc?
Nailed it! Score one for the king of comedy, Ryuji!
Although I have to say, the act has gotten a little stale by now.
I believe I speak for the panel when I say we would appreciate more animated gestures next time.
Maybe incorporating some props into your routine would spruce it up.
When did I say I was taking notes?
What's this? Are you over here mocking our hideout?
Oh no, we wouldn't think of it. No mocking here.
Hey, who's this strange lot? Well, they're actually... I see. So you stumbled upon them, and they're trying to determine whether or not to join the Rebel Club. I suppose we are desperate. A cat would make a good ally in our circumstances.
You better watch your tongue, buddy.
Before we agree to anything, though, would you mind sharing a bit more on what's happening? We heard something about a tyrant earlier. What else can you tell us about that?
In a nutshell, he's a ruthless monster. But he has no problem throwing others under the bus, so long as he gets something out of it. That's right! We all trusted him, and the traitor stabbed us in the back! That bastard took away someone very close to me. If only it weren't for... It's time he got what he deserves.
What was that?
Every single one of us here has been put through hell by...
Huh. We can't hear him say the name. What's the deal there? Weird, right? What do you think is doing that?
Enough backstory. Are you going to help us or not?
Just to be clear first, you do know how we can get out of here, right?
Fine. We'll tell you this one thing for now. This is top secret, mind you. Recently, we were able to confirm the location of the Legionnaire's leader. But the place is locked up so tightly, none of us can get in. We can only break in if we find all four keys to the door.
And what's that got to do with us? We're looking for an exit, not a fight.
We've searched every other place in this building, and we haven't found a single way out. But we've never seen what's behind that locked door. Which means...
Which means...
They've already searched everywhere else and still haven't found an exit. There's a real chance we'll find what we're looking for beyond that door. I believe that's their logic. I suppose this means we do share a common goal. Yes? I'm sorry, but I have a selfish request. Having come this far already, I'm determined to get to the bottom of my memory issue. That in mind, would you be willing to assist them, even temporarily?
Yes, I think that'd be best. Besides, we don't have any other leads at the moment. Why don't we see if confronting this kingdom's ruler will do us any good?
That sounds like a plan to me.
Thank you. Hopefully I can remember something useful.
That settles it. We're joining the Rebel Club.
Glad to hear it. Welcome aboard, everyone. As of this moment, you're officially members of the Rebel Club. We'll root out and confront this evil as one.
Yeah, we're that much closer to success.
So, do you know where any of the keys are?
According to our investigations, there are strange-looking doors spread across the building. You should find them beyond those doors, in a horrible pocket dimension.
We've already been through one of those. So there are more of them, huh?
The closest one is in the courtyard. Once you're properly equipped, please head there and acquire it for us.
Bet they're all crawling with enemies. Well, nothing new to us.
You said it. Well, let's suit up and get going.
I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Sounds good. Whatever.
All right, let's head out.
I can never get in the right mood for this stuff in my normal outfit. Hope it kicks in when the time comes.
The courtyard is over on the other end of this floor. There's no time to waste. Ready, set, go! Best of luck in battle!
Man, these guys. I can't tell if they're gung-ho or just bossy.
We'll continue our own preparations here for the final battle with that awful tyrant.
Let's move out. We've got a key to track down.
I wonder which part of the building we're in now.
Still, the first floor would be my guess.
I don't know about you guys, but isn't this place a vibe? You know, not shadows or legionnaires, but that other scary stuff.
Wait, no! You don't mean... Huh.
Oh, it's nothing major. My mind keeps coming back to one thing. Don't the beings here seem more riled up than the ones in the last two kingdoms?
Would there be a reason behind it?
If so, then my money would be on your recent change of mindset. I mean, if this world does exist in your heart, it'd make sense for changes to your state of mind to influence the place.
Oh, so it's because Toshiro decided he was going to fight back?
It stands to reason. Once Toshiro was emboldened, so were the other beings.
He's gone from the runaway old-timer to the sort of defiant old-timer.
Well, being around you criminals was bound to toughen me up a bit.
You really had the spine of a block of tofu when we first met, didn't you, Tofuro?
Arena, you still need to grow up a bit yourself. Aren't you roughly the same age as these kids? You need to learn to respect your elders or life is going to be...
Yeah, I know.
Why, you... I'm not putting up with this anymore.
Good grief. Those two haven't matured at all, have they?
Okay, enough of this for now.
We've got work.
Yeah, let's do what we gotta do to find our ticket out of here.
Is this the right place?
This can't be. A rather pleasant courtyard. One could easily find a place to sit back, relax, and enjoy a bento.
Dreaming of food even now, Inari? I could go for lunch myself, but we've got that to take care of first. Yeah, that. I'm sure some other fresh hell awaits us on the other side.
But the rebels told us that's where the key is, right?
Along with a heap of legionnaires too, no doubt. Time to work up an appetite.
I hear you there. Just thinking about going through one of those doors again gives me the heebie-jeebies.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained. Let's just get what we came for and return as soon as possible.
Toshiro, something bugging you?
Oh, it's nothing.
I could swear. Where have I seen this place?
Okay, folks. On the count of three, like last time. One, two, three!
Would you like to create a weapon? Select a persona. Please read. You wish to withdraw this persona? Select a persona. Please read this. You wish to withdraw this persona? Select a persona. Please read. You wish to withdraw this persona? What would you like to do? You wish to dismantle a weapon. Which weapon will you choose? Which weapon will you choose? Are you finished? Would you like to create a weapon? What would you like to do? Would you like to create? Are you finished? You wish to dismantle a weapon. Which one will you choose? What would you like to do? Do you wish to perform a fusion? Now then, make your decision. Which persona will you choose? Now then, make your decision. Is this persona? Please wait just a moment. Which persona will you choose? Now then, make your decision. Which persona will you choose? Is this persona? One moment, please. Now then, make your decision. Is this persona? Please wait just a moment. Which persona will you choose? Is this persona? One moment, please. Are you finished? Until next time.
Ready. Wipe them off, Goemon! Time to raise the curtain! Wipe them out!
Nice position! You'll be well hidden!
Get ready!
Now it's my turn!
I'm perfectly ready!
Nice cover!
Persona!
Let's do this!
Better get ready!
Cut them down!
Leave it to me!
Now it's my turn!
I'm perfectly ready!
Get ready.
Wipe them out!
Let's do this!
Alright, let's do this!
I'll cut them down.
Get ready!
Now it's my turn!
Wipe them out!
Leave it to me!
Alright, let's do this!
I'll cut them down.
I'll follow you up!
Better get ready!
Won't miss.
It's a direct hit! Fox, you're on a roll!
Let's do this.
Alright, let's do this.
I'll cut them down.
Get ready.
Now it's my turn.
I'm perfectly ready. Why should we be
gonna get ready.
Get ready.
All right, let's do this.
perfectly ready.
Excellent position, Bob.
I am now.
Do it, right?
So, where's this key we're looking for? Did it drop somewhere?
I don't see anything of the sort so far.
Hold up! I've got a reading!
This is what was shining? These aren't keys, though.
Yep, no mistaking it. Those are bandages.
Really? Sorry, but could I see those for a moment?
Could that be this late in the evening?
Come in.
Ah, there you are. I heard I'd find you here. Huh? You look fine, more or less.
Hmm?
I'm sorry, but I don't believe we've met. Perhaps you're mistaking me for someone else.
No, you're definitely who I've been looking for. Toshiro Kasukabe, Mr. Class President.
Well, I suppose you're not mistaken then. What did you need to discuss with me?
Relax. No need to be so formal with me. It's not like I have to have a reason to be here. This is the student council room, and I am a student.
You have an upperclassman uniform, but I haven't seen you here before. Are you a new transfer?
All business, aren't you? You got me, though. I already knew this school was fancy, but they push the decorum here pretty hard, don't they? I'll pick it up eventually, and if not, then no biggie. I got curious about you, so I started asking around. Pretty impressive rep you've got there. A ton of talent, a connected family, stellar grades, your whole future set up. You even got elected student council president as a first year. Nobody done that here before you.
Why are you describing me to myself? Is this some kind of awkward ribbing? If you don't have any council business, please see yourself out. I'm quite busy here.
Oh, sorry if I upset you. I'm just interested in you, I swear. I mean, getting beat up by a whole gang of delinquents? They don't even do that in manga anymore.
So you saw that?
I even thought for a second that I'd find you here all covered in bandages.
What a bizarre way of thinking.
Still, you jumped into that mess by yourself, all to help that other student getting mugged, didn't you? You're not just a president. You're a student council superhero. You know, I actually like the sound of that.
I wasn't doing anything so noble. I merely happened on the scene. Once I knew what was going on, I had no choice but to get involved. I also only became student council president because it'll look good on my college application. Besides, My father told me I need experience as a public figure to ensure I can take up the family's work. But never mind all that, I'm digressing. What I mean to say is I've learned a valuable lesson about poking my nose into other people's business.
Huh. Still, you ended up rescuing the kid, right?
Well, those miscreants seemed too tired to go back to bullying him once they had their fill assaulting me. Don't you have somewhere to be? It's well past time for students to still...
Oh, right. I haven't introduced myself yet. I'm Eri Natsuhara. Nice to meet ya. Kasukabe-kun, I've got a hunch about you. This is where you usually hang out after school, right? I'll drop by and bug you again later.
Huh?
See ya. Oh, my bad. I meant to give you this earlier. Here. See ya.
What are... Some bandages. What is with that girl?
Mm-hmm. Hey! Was that?
Yeah. I bet we saw the same thing. I still can't wrap my head around it, though.
That was so full of twists, I don't even know where to start.
That was Toshiro in the uniform, yeah? The student council president?
Yeah, I was wondering about that, too. Going by appearance, she and Arena were...
We've got a lot to hammer out. We should take these on one by one. Good point. Now that we have what seems to be the key in this place, we can get out of here. Yep. We'll have plenty to talk about on the other side of the door.
Saw together. That wasn't a figment of our imaginations.
You mean we witnessed something that actually took place?
Yes, I'm sure of it. Although, I'd forgotten the event entirely until now. The girl who showed up was Eri Natsuhara. She was one of my senpai on the student council.
Context.
From what I noticed, it seemed to be the first meeting between the two of them.
Toshiro, have you remembered anything else yet?
Well, that was when I first met Natsuhara-senpai. She joined the council shortly after, and...
She had you totally whipped?
That's an awful way to put it, but it's unfortunately not far from the truth either. Regardless, she was also the kind of person who couldn't stand mistreatment or injustice. Whenever she caught wind of problems with the school or students in trouble, she'd run to me with a report. Every time she would try to convince me with a, Toshiro, let's fight the good fight. I initially agreed to help so I could keep tabs on her. She was such a reckless student council member. Before I knew it, she had us running all over the school together. We tackled all sorts of issues at that school. Bullying, unfair school rules. Heck, by the end, we were even giving career and relationship advice. At some point, the student council room became more of a counseling room for the average student. The students were always grateful whenever we were able to help them. I found that especially gratifying, since I was fed up with my father's alternative expectations for me. Looking back at the time, I think we did a lot of good together. And then... That's all I'm able to remember. But why? I can't. It's like something's fogging my memory.
Hey, don't push it too hard. We all shared that vision when you touched the bandage. That's what restored your memory. There are supposed to be 4 keys, right? Maybe we can learn more from finding the others.
True. And there are still a few more things I want to get to the bottom of. Especially about Natsuhara-senpai. And you as well, Irina.
There's a bit too much resemblance for it to be a coincidence, huh?
Totally. They even have the same chemistry together.
Think so? I mean, we may look similar, but I don't boss you around that much. Right, Toshiro?
Really? What do you expect me to say?
It's more like he's in the palm of your hand and you're crushing him.
Yeah, as flat as a pancake.
Well, is that really how you all see me?
I have to admit, though, there's one thing that's been stuck on my mind. It's been nagging me ever since we came to this world. When I saw the visions of Toshiro's memory, I felt something stirring in my own head. That girl. She's someone from your own world, right? Ever since I heard we're in a world made from Toshiro's heart, I've been thinking, what am I, exactly?
Irina, I have a few ideas I could share, but nothing for certain. Ultimately, I have a feeling you're entirely different from any of the entities we're familiar with.
I see. Right. No matter what I turn out to be, in the end, I'm still me.
Nailed it! No matter what you are, you'll always be you. Just like Mona will always be a cat, yeah?
Check the transitive property, pal. And keep me out of your analogies.
Thanks, guys. Well, no use thinking about it now. How about we get back to it? We've still got 3 more things to find, right?
Yep, now that we've got the one, let's head back to the Rebel Club room next.
Yeah, especially since we can assume another fight's waiting for us behind the next door. Let's head back and find out where the next one is.
We sure have a lot of choices. I'll be counting on you.
So that's it.
Whoa!
Oh. Good idea.
Oh, I see.
Of course.
Thank you.
like to create a weapon? What would you like to do? Would you like to create a weapon? Are you finished? Would you like to look at the Persona Compendium? Then please take a look. Read this. You wish to withdraw this persona? One moment, please. What would you like to do? Are you finished? Would you like to create a weapon? You wish to dismantle a weapon? Which weapon will you choose? Are you finished? Until next time.
Raise the curtain.
Do here.
As always, Joker, you got him!
I'll put them down. I am now. Wait up! Persona! Wipe them out! Throw him off!
The only enemy unbeaten! Great stuff!
Here I go!
Wipe them out!
I'm ready!
Alright.
I'm perfectly ready.
Here I go!
Wipe them out!
Now.
Persona! I'm perfectly ready. Time to raise the curtain.
All right, come back again later. Wait a minute. Seriously? Really?
That's right.
What if...
Understood.
You gotta be...
Docket for this key hunt.
The next key is located in the cafeteria.
The cafeteria, you say? How do the meal plans work here? If I can't enroll, could I at least start a tab?
Rein it in, Inari. Let's focus on the job first, all right?
And I'm sure your tab at Kose is bad enough already.
Considering how hostile this place can get, you'd better not try sneaking any food.
Right? Well, I can understand getting hungry, but we've got a job waiting for us in that cafeteria.
If I had to wager, I'd guess it's on the second floor. Is that right?
That's correct. Just go up the nearest stairwell, continue on straight, and you'll find it.
Sounds like you already knew that, though. So you better not waste any more time and just get going.
I did, didn't I? Whatever the case may be, we should get going. I'll lead the way, if you don't mind. If everyone's ready.
This floor of the building ultimately looks the same as the last.
The cafeteria should be just ahead. Let's hurry.
Hey, Toshiro. Is this the same school that you went to?
Yes. It's quite some time since I graduated, but I can tell that I'm slowly starting to remember.
It may be distorted or inaccurate here and there, but I can say with absolute certainty that this is the same building.
Any idea who could be in charge here?
Can you remember anyone who caused problems for you? Maybe the other students?
No, it hasn't all come back yet.
Scum! I can't believe it's you. So you're the lowlife disturbing my sacred place.
That voice. Who is that?
Leave now, or suffer the consequences.
Speak of the devil! So, I guess I'm talking to the big cheese, yeah? Look, I don't know who you are, but get in our way and we'll mess you up. Got it?
You'll mess me up? You idiot. You have no idea what that would do.
Who are you already?
Who am I? You mean you've forgotten? But you're the one who knows me best.
That's it.
Whoever it was,
it sounded like you recognized me.
Damn it, if only I could remember.
Well, I suppose this is the first unknown kingdom ruler we've encountered.
We're likely coming to blows with another eccentric character, like Marie and Yoshiki were.
He's the one making life tough for those guys back at the hideout, yeah? Well, I'm all for punching the guy out, but we need to collect whatever these keys are supposed to be for that to happen.
I'm picking up a big open space just ahead of us. Looks like Toshiro was right on the money. That's our next destination.
So this is their cafeteria? Oh, it's pretty huge.
It certainly feels like the quintessential cafeteria. This room has the nicest vibe of the whole building.
I believe I'm remembering more now.
The food here was quite popular, especially for the price. I heard that this place was constantly packed with students in lines during lunchtime.
You heard? So you never actually ate here?
I was never one for crowded places like this. From what I remember, I was always cooped up in the student council room with a homemade bento.
Boy, do I relate to that. The cafeterias are for normies. Definitely not my kind of scene. I'd probably explode if I ever got forced to eat in one!
It's not life or death. It's just a food room.
Look, another one of those doors!
Time to find out what the second key is.
Down.
do my best.
What to do here?
Nice position. You'll be well hidden.
Wipe them out.
I'm ready. Let's do this!
ready.
All right.
All right, Joker! Nice hiding spot!
Let's go!
All right, Joker! Nice hiding spot!
Let's go!
You saved me. Wipe them out.
That's perfect. You'll be safe there.
Persona! Come, my other self. I am thou. Wipe them out. Throw him off. Wipe them out.
I'm ready.
I'll cut them down.
Here I go.
Wipe them out.
I'll do my best.
Very smooth, Noir. You really are the beauty. That's perfect. You'll be safe
my
there.
Power. Persona!
I'm perfectly ready. Persona! Prepare yourself!
I'm ready!
Nice positioning, Noir! That's perfect!
Time
you'll be safe
you.
There!
Slice you!
That settles the matter. Now, for this second so-called key.
Look, over there!
Oh, that's a weird-looking box.
Oh, I remember learning about this in history class. Something in the Edo period?
It's a suggestion box. Basically, it's a way to collect people's complaints and requests anonymously. Although, this one appears to be empty.
Think this'll jog any memories, Toshiro?
I can't say for sure, but if it's the same as last time...
Yep, you called it.
So tired. I pulled an all-nighter on a mock exam. Entrance exams might be important, but that doesn't change the fact that they suck.
Overnight cramming is actually counterproductive. Sleep is necessary for committing what you've learned to memory. You might make it by cramming for regular tests, but comprehensive ones like entrance exams require long-term memory for any chance.
Oh good, I can get some shut-eye during this lecture.
I don't give you lectures, I give you advice. Which you clearly need. If anything, I should lecture you on how to take advice properly.
Yeah. By the way, I noticed earlier, the suggestion box has been awfully empty lately.
If I had to guess, I'd say it's because we've taken care of everything by now. You're going to run yourself ragged if you're always looking for trouble to clean up, Eri.
You're saying I should turn a blind eye to people in need? That'll run me even more ragged.
Please, try putting yourself in my shoes for once. Can't you just enjoy the peace and quiet as the fruits of your labor?
I sure hope you're right. But something's still bugging me. Isn't the vibe at school kinda weird now?
Weird?
Come in!
Hi. Someone said that you guys hear out people in trouble?
Yep, whatever it is, you can lay it on your future prime minister here.
Don't say such ridiculous things.
How come? One day you'll be a Diet member and then you'll make prime minister, yeah?
I've never said anything of the sort.
What? You don't remember your speech? I'll never take favors from my father. I'll stand on my own 2 feet.
I've definitely never said that. You must do the worst impression I've ever seen.
Huh? Objection, Your Honor. Wait, is that a prime minister or a judge?
Sorry.
Here, grab a seat and hit us with the deets.
Vice Principal Nakabachi's been blackmailing students and staff here?
I was such an idiot. I thought my chances at college, my whole life, would be over if the school found out I'd been working at a nightclub.
And when Nakabachi stumbled onto your secret, he proposed a deal to keep you off the hook. He ordered you to dig up dirt on other students and report back to him, correct?
Then he'd use that information to pressure them into bringing him even more dirt on other people. He just kept creating more and more victims until eventually he even had the teachers under his thumb.
There's no way to tell who's working for Nakabachi, so I didn't know who to trust with this. And it's all my fault. I did something so stupid just to pay my tuition. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Sorry for melting down like that. So, now what?
Thank you for telling us. I know it wasn't easy. This is a pretty huge issue, so it's gonna take some time, but we'll handle it.
I don't care what happens to me anymore. So please, I'm begging you, please!
Nakabachi was hired here very recently, but he was promoted to vice principal right away. It may have been unexpected, but nobody would guess this was how he pulled it off. Any student here would be terrified to lose their college prospects. It's no wonder how he was able to exploit that.
That's just sick. How could he use people and torture them like that?
It sounds like the entire school's in a bizarre standoff, what with everyone spying on each other for Nakabachi. This certainly explains why you felt something off here. That said, this is clearly beyond the scope of what the student council can handle. If we make one wrong move, we could be done for ourselves. What's your take, Eri? Eri?
Ugh, God! I am so pissed right now! I don't care how badly Nakabachi wants to be in charge. He has no right to put Yuri through that kind of hell. I thought schools and the staff were supposed to protect students. But not this messed up place. The way he's running this school now, it's like his own little dictatorship or something. He's done for if he's really doing this. Toshiro, you've got to help me.
I thought you'd say as much. From the sounds of things, you're looking to assemble a full-on rebellion.
Toshiro, that's exactly it. We'll start a rebellion. Ah, great idea.
Please don't take my jokes at face value. At any rate, we're going to investigate this. I have to know the truth. That's right. Nakabachi. Ichiro Nakabachi. He was just a run-of-the-mill music teacher who got promoted to vice principal. After hearing Yuri's story, Eri and I went around the school investigating. Turning up leads wasn't easy, but Eri was persistent enough that we eventually had a grasp of the situation. Simply put, the results were jaw-dropping. Sexual harassment, embezzlement, extortion, other abuses of power, all of it being covered up by the administration. And to top it all off, Nakabachi had been promised a promotion to principal. He essentially had full reign of the school.
Ugh, another turd for a teacher.
The world's a big place. Big enough for plenty of pieces of shit to run their schools.
To blackmail his own student. Can't imagine how Yuri felt at the time.
But Nakabachi had covered his tracks. So ultimately, we weren't able to collect any conclusive evidence. Without concrete proof, we had to put our hopes on the victims' testimonies.
What is it? Did they testify?
I'm sorry. I can't remember the rest.
Well, we certainly learned enough this time around to put one question to bed.
I'd wager that the ruler of this kingdom is Vice Principal Nakabachi.
And I bet you're right. Now, let's wrap this up so we can get out of here already.
Well, at least we've got an idea of who might be running this place. Plus the second key to boot. Let's go back to the hideout so we can hammer out our next step.
Until next time.
Hey. Actually,
thank you. What?
That's right.
Ah.
Sounds good.
We're back with the second key. Next up's the third one.
The third one already? That's even further from here. It's somewhere within the faculty room.
Somewhere within, huh?
The faculty room, huh? Can I maybe skip out on this one?
I wonder why, Ryuji. Maybe it's all the chewing out from your teachers?
I doubt anyone has good memories of that place. No reason to be there, except getting chewed out.
I don't know if that's entirely true.
So far, we've been sent to the courtyard, the cafeteria, and now the faculty room. No. I'm sure there's a connection with my memories, but I still haven't come up with anything else. However, I do feel like we're getting close. Sure, we'll find out more once we secure what... Let's move out. My memory may be vague, but I can still guide you there. The faculty room should be just ahead of here.
Walking all over this school's a pain, but I guess it still beats getting wrapped up in some other drama.
Yes. It's nice how it seems we won't be attacked while merely walking around the school.
Whatever's on the other side of the doors is definitely a different situation. What's up with that anyway?
Furthermore, there's another matter I don't understand. Despite our assumptions about this kingdom, we've been attacked by creatures more closely resembling students than teachers. What could be the cause of that? Is there even a reason?
Whatever the reason, it's obvious that we're still facing a lot of unknown factors.
Let's just hurry up and catch the next episode of Toshiro's Put Upon Adventure.
A school tale where Toshiro's whipped, huh? I'd like to learn the ending.
Whipped? Ending?
Would you mind if we moved on?
Yes. Sorry.
But that Matsuhara-san really is straight as an arrow, isn't she? She was genuinely concerned for that girl, and never had second thoughts about helping her.
Now that I'm thinking about it, Harry was actually somewhat similar to you all.
Really?
She was a fervent believer in justice. She always had a very strong sense of empathy. Remember how, when we first met, I said I had a less than favorable opinion of the Phantom Thieves? Well, I'm fairly certain I was just envious of your ability to accomplish what I never could. I'd like to take back what I said. I'm sorry.
Aw, cut him some slack. His memory was a real mess back then, remember?
Being able to reflect upon one's faults is an admirable quality to foster. I make a point to reflect upon my mistakes each time I find myself having to eat wild grass for lack of funds.
I think you might need to do more than reflect.
Besides, there's nothing to apologize for. You're an adult, and a politician to boot.
Not everything we do is condonable to everyone. We certainly always have that in mind.
Understood. I'll remember that. Marina, I owe you an apology as well. How should I put this?
Don't worry about it. I think I already know, kind of. Let's keep moving for now. We can talk more later.
Right. Well, let's be off. Lead the way.
Losers, get your asses out here so I can kick them.
You're making it sound like we're raiding the place.
Classy, Ryuji.
What, you want me to bow first? If we can make him freak before we fight him, we should do it.
Oh, I gotcha.
I'm pretty sure a door like that means they're not hearing anything we say on the other side.
Do you think they can even understand us?
We know what to expect on the other side. Let's do this!
That's it, dipshits! We're coming for you now!
Yeah, dipshits! You're gonna regret making us come in there!
Like I said, let's do this! Before Ryuji's potty mouth rubs off on Arena any worse.
Thank you.
perfectly ready. Time to raise the curtain. Wipe them off, throw him off.
Now then.
Wipe them out.
Here I go.
Now,
I'm perfectly ready.
All right.
Wipe them out. Wipe them out.
Here I go.
Now,
I'm perfectly ready.
I'm ready.
What to do here?
I'll cut them down.
You'll get no mercy.
All right.
I'm perfectly ready.
All right.
ready. Prepare yourself.
Here I go.
What to do here?
I'll cut them down. Time to raise the curtain.
I'm ready. Take him out.
What to do here?
Let's go. I'm perfectly ready. Prepare yourself. My other self, whoever!
All right.
You'll get no mercy! Persona! Get ready to ride, Johanna!
Wipe them out!
Here I go! Now you will feel my rage!
All right.
I'll cut them down.
I'm ready!
What to do here?
Here I go.
I'm perfectly ready.
You'll get no mercy.
I'll cut them down. I'll hold you back. I'm perfectly ready. I'll slice you into pieces.
You'll get no mercy.
Wipe them out!
You'll get no mercy!
What to do here?
I'm perfectly ready.
Here I go!
All right.
I'll cut them down.
I'm ready!
Now,
I'm perfectly ready.
Here I go!
What to do here?
I'll cut them down.
I'm ready!
Now,
I'm perfectly ready.
Here I go!
All right.
Great positioning, Joker!
Come!
Let's go. Wipe them out.
I'm ready.
All right.
Insolence.
Ready. Wipe them out!
Here I go!
What to do here?
I'm perfectly ready.
You'll get no mercy!
Now,
I'll cut you down. Wipe them out! Nothing but a stain upon my sword!
Yeah! Just like that!
Take this!
What to do here?
You'll get no mercy!
All right.
Let's end.
No match for us.
Suck on that. The Phantom Thieves showed you what's up.
With that out of the way, where's that key? Ooh, over there.
A letter? Any letter. Front says it's a letter of challenge.
That's the third key?
Look at the weight of the brush strokes. Whoever wrote this meant business.
That looks like... No. It's probably best to see what happened first.
Is everyone ready? Here it comes.
Perhaps one of you would care to explain the meaning of this letter. How about you, Kasukabe? It was scrawled so furiously, I was barely able to read it.
A letter of challenge? Senpai, did you really write this? I know I left it to you to call him out, but this is pretty hokey. And you even included our names?
What's wrong with that? We needed to confront him face to face. Honestly, it would have been better to go yell at him in the faculty room. Calling him into this empty music room was to show him the slightest amount of mercy.
Here I was wondering what the blazes this could be about. You really wanted an in-person confrontation? You tricked me here with some baseless accusations. Now you expect me to actually apologize for them?
An apology's not going to cut it. You're going to confess your crimes and turn yourself into the police.
Surely you're jesting.
You won't be talking your way out of this. A whole list of students shared the truth with us.
A list of students, you say? I don't know who'd spout such lies, but I can assure you this nonsense won't prove a thing.
It isn't nonsense! We only found out because someone came to us for help.
Do you have a name of this someone? And what evidence do you have to corroborate their story? Now, hypothetically speaking, let's say you're correct. Just how many people do you see here backing you two up? Your theory's riddled with flaws, wouldn't you say? For example, if there are as many victims as you claim, why hasn't a single one come forth?
That's because you've screwed them all over!
Senpai, please don't touch him. Laying a hand on him would give him just what he wants.
Ah, Kasukabe, my boy. Good to know you still see reason. That must be your father's doing. I, for one, hope Representative Kasukabe has a long and fruitful career. Well, let's end this discussion here. No matter how much of a fit you may pitch, no one is going to take your side. Not unless every single one of your so-called list of students steps forward. Ah, but that's quite the unless, isn't it? Best of luck there.
Hang on! We're not done here!
Eri, don't chase him!
That bastard! Cackling like some kind of kids' show villain!
He certainly seems confident.
He's forced each victim into a position where betraying him means self-ruin.
Fear is certainly an effective method of control. Though not just their fear. I've gotten the sense that some people even expected perks from Nakabachi for obeying him.
We can raise all the fuss we like, but if the victims have no intention of accusing him...
I don't care. He's still wrong. And what's gonna happen? Everyone's just supposed to let him get away with it? Does everyone really need to come forth? If so, we'll try persuading them again by...
Tell me, Senpai. Why do you care so much? I know just how much you value honesty and how you can't stand injustice, but...
It's not about caring. I just do what I do because I want to. Okay. I think I can tell you. You see... Back at my last school, one of my classmates framed me for some theft, and everyone ended up shunning me. It was over something stupid. I can't remember if it was a notebook or some perfume, but something was stolen.
How awful.
I'm sure there were some folks who thought I was a nuisance, considering my personality. But in the end, even my closest friends all left me. At the time, I was more shocked than angry, so I kept my mouth shut and just tried to deal with it. After a while, my homeroom teacher noticed I'd been acting differently, so she reached out to me. I didn't want to stir things up, so I told her to leave me alone. But then she told me, silence in the face of injustice is complicity. If your gut tells you something's wrong, why not fight back, she asked. That was the push I needed to change my attitude. I've fought back ever since. I got all kinds of people involved. I asked around school for leads, I searched for the stolen stuff myself. And with that teacher's help, I was able to prove my innocence. That said, the whole mess drew a lot of negative attention, so I still wound up transferring.
Ah, so that's why you transferred here at such an odd time.
Honestly, I think the reason I get so worked up is because I'm actually a coward at heart.
You? A coward?
If we lived in the kind of world where corruption was free to flourish, it'd feel like everything I fought for was a waste. There'd be no reason to take a stand for what's right. That's the reality I'm afraid of. I simply can't allow it.
No matter your reasoning, I think it's admirable. You're simply following your own sense of justice.
Admittedly, that doesn't apply to what I do.
Well, thanks. But I think you're wrong about yourself. The first time I ever saw you was pretty telling. I knew you're someone who does the right thing. Considering their numbers, you were really putting your life on the line there.
Oh, that old story. I keep telling you, I just felt like it.
Still, was I ever glad to meet you here. It was almost like meeting another me.
So, what's the next move? Nakabachi's not confessing, and I doubt any of his cronies will either. We've gotta find something else.
Toshiro, you're sure?
You think I can just slink out of here after all you've said? Plus, I need to keep an eye on you if you decide to go loose cannon. Besides...
That must be your father's doing. I, for one, hope Representative Kasukabe has a long and fruitful career.
You'll see. I'll show him what I can do.
Over.
Oh, what a week ending! Not even a preview of the next one?
You guys do remember we're watching that guy's real life, right?
So that's why.
Whoa, it's weird when they sync up. What's the deal?
Maybe I've seen one too many of Toshiro's memories. But, yeah. Those things that Eri had said... If we lived in the kind of world where corruption is free to flourish, that's the reality I'm afraid of. I simply can't allow it. I have to say, I'm not sure how we may be related. I'm scared that we're entering a world where corruption is free to flourish. And even worse, I'm scared of becoming someone who's okay with that. But I can tell she has the same feelings that I've had for as long as I can remember.
I must admit, the two of you have a very strong drive towards justice. Even at your own expense.
Oh, you think so?
In that case, I'm even more puzzled about the two of you now.
I don't really know how to phrase it. But the more I think about how Toshiro's past may have some meaning for me, the more it's like... Yeah, I'm okay. Thanks for asking. Let's just keep moving for now. The answer must be right around the corner. Right, Toshiro?
Yeah, I'm right there with you. Our next move should be securing the location of the last key.
Then let's shut up and get out of here!
Can't wait to curl up back at the hideout.
Sure have a lot of choices.
Until next time!
Which should we choose?
Quite.
So that means...
Wait, you mean... Whoa! What?
Well, you see...
That's enough.
I see.
What to do?
Ready.
The target's still far away. Make
All
sure
right,
you pace
let's
yourself.
Do this.
Let's do this.
I'll cut them down.
Now it's my turn.
I'm perfectly ready.
All right,
Need
let's do
meat.
This.
Down.
We're halfway there.
Now
Keep
it's
up,
my
folks.
Turn.
Get ready.
I'm perfectly ready.
All right, let's do this.
Them out.
Now it's my turn.
Leave it to me. It's over for you.
Zoro! All right, let's do
I'm
this.
Perfectly ready.
Nice! Keep it up!
Now it's my turn!
Got it! Let's go! Here!
What?
Advance! Ha!
Now!
Let's go! Fire!
Such insolence!
Advance!
Oh man! Enemy reinforcements!
Better get ready!
I'll cut them down.
Let's do this!
Wipe them out!
Leave it to me!
Alright, let's do this!
Let's do this!
I'm perfectly ready.
Better get ready!
Leave it to me!
cut them down.
All right, let's do this.
And that's a hit. Good job, Skull. Let's do this.
Wipe them out. Wipe them out.
Leave it to me.
I'm perfectly ready.
All right, let's do this.
I'll cut them down.
Better get ready.
Leave it to me.
I'm perfectly ready.
All right, let's do this.
Get ready.
Wipe them out.
Now it's my turn.
Let's do this. Hit him hard.
You gotta hit, Mona. Now do it again.
Oh, perfectly ready.
Looks promising.
All right, let's do this.
Leave it to me.
Get ready.
Wipe them out.
Now it's my turn.
Cut them down. Wipe them out.
Now it's my turn.
Get ready.
I'm perfectly ready.
Better get ready.
Leave it to me.
I'll cut them down.
All right, let's do this.
Behold the proof of my determination.
Mona defeated an enemy. Everyone, follow his lead.
Now it's my turn.
Wipe them out.
Better get ready.
Perfectly ready. won't escape!
A direct hit! Bugs, you're on a roll!
All right, let's do this!
Wipe them out! I am thou. I will follow you out.
A direct hit! Bugs, you're on a roll!
Get ready! Time to go wild! This.
You've got this, Mona!
I'm
nice
perfectly
cover.
Ready.
Now it's my turn!
Leave it to me!
Wipe them out! You won't escape!
Okay,
you.
We're down!
Right.
Thank you.